Hello skaters, and thanks for tuning in. In today's workout, we're going to look at how you can master your inline skates. It's going to be some balance exercises, there's going to be some mobility, a lot of range of motion, and then some control exercises where you're going to either jump and then try and regain your balance as fast as possible, or where there's going to be an extreme weight transfer. Some of them might look a little strange, but give it a try. And remember rule number one, nobody's ever too good to not practice the basics.
As I'm showing the exercises, I am going to make some technical comments here to help you guys avoid some of the most common mistakes. This one is super simple. You don't want to fall too far backwards or too far out front, even though it's a little difficult because it takes a lot of flexibility in the angles. Try and put your knees forward. The skate skipping is all about maintaining that position. Remember, these are not jumps, they're just quick weight transfers. So stay low at all time. You wanna catch the skate or catch that position super low, and you also wanna jump from one skate or move from one skate to the other in that low position. Work on a smooth and fast arm swing so it's coordinated at all time. This is definitely gonna make it easier for you to maintain balance. Even though it's fast movements, make sure that the leg that is called the recovery leg behind is as relaxed as it can be. Skate jumps, a little bit of the same thing here. Don't let the upper body get too far up in the air when you're jumping. Here's the load and transfer. That is one of my personal favorites. This is all about the rhythm. When you get from this high position down into the skating, make sure that you really sink onto that skate before you move to the side. Otherwise, you're gonna lose that pressure before you actually push off with it. So let it all come together down into that perfect 90 degrees knee angle before you move from side to side. I'm gonna show one more time here. So you go up there, dive into it, and then once you get down to the skating position, you use that weight without letting the knees cave in, without falling too far in the inner edge of the frame. You go to the side. Engage the hips, engage everything to make a smooth sideways movement. Here's a one leg squat. Keep the shoulders relaxed, keep everything pointing forward, especially that skate that you have hanging up in the air. This is gonna be a big challenge, the skater pistols. If possible, do these indoors or somewhere where you can allow yourself to crash if that was gonna happen. It is difficult. You might even notice it here on the screen that I'm a little shaky when I'm down in position, even though I've been doing inline skating drills once or twice a day for the last 15 years of my life. Here we're gonna take it to the next level, backwards one leg squats. This is definitely difficult. It even took me a few attempts before I got this video in, so that's okay if you're struggling. This one is the same, but just staying in that position. As you can see, I was a little shake here. Dryskate or almost kill zone is just really smooth skating in a super low position, where you are extra patient, so you let that body weight use the body weight to fold from side to side. Here's the crisscross. It's really about loosening up the hips. You need a lot of mobility to perform this one well and a lot of stability. But even though we won't skate like this, it's a great way to improve your corner technique.
Make sure that you subscribe and stay tuned, because it's gonna be a lot of cool videos, a lot of cool exercises, and I'm sure they can help you improve.